Today we will learn how to create a form and save information in the database. We will use a list of subscribers as an example. We will start by creating a new table and we must set a name and a single name. After that, we will add three fields. One for the full name, which will be a text type. One for the age, which will be a number type field. And also we're going to add an email. It will also be a text type field, but we will use a validation option to verify that it is, in fact, a valid email. When we create a table, Aptugo automatically creates a page where we can verify said table. So we will go to the pages section and drag this page as a child of the dashboard so we can view it. We build and verify that it has been created correctly. Now, we will go to our main page, in which we only have a sidebar. The first thing we need to create our form is the load from database element, which allows us to access the tables we have in our database. First, we must select the table that we want to load and give it a variable name that will store the data. To display the form, we will use the container element and select the small size as max width, only to center the fields for aesthetic purposes. Then we will look for the field element, which will allow us to display the fields that we want to use to add data in our database. We select in the field option a field of the table, and in the type option, we will select the type edit, which will allow us to edit the field. We will repeat the same procedure for each field of our table. After this, let's save, build, and verify that all the fields have been rendered. Now, to save into the database, we need to create a function. For this, we will use the function element and give it the name subscribe. In the body of the function is where we will start to add all the magic. We will create a variable called data, which will receive through the JavaScript spread operator all the information that we add in the form input. Then, to clear the information in the form, we use the setSubscribersData function and also pass the initial data subscribers variable with the spread operator, which Aptugo created automatically for us when doing the load from database at the beginning. Finally, to apply the functionality of saving to the database, we must use the save to database element and place it as a child of the function element. In the data field, we select the database table in which we want to save, and in variable name to save, we add the name of the variable that we want to store in our table. In this case, the data variable we created earlier. The last step is to add a button inside the form, which will execute the save function when clicked. In the button text field, we add a text, and in the action field, we put the name of the function that we want to execute, followed by parentheses, in our case, subscribe. Then we save, do a last build, and try to load some data. Let's click the button and verify that the data was actually saved.